stuff on you? I'm Lila McKenna, and I believe that positivity is contagious, so we should try to be positive. The definition of positivity is focusing on the good rather than the negative aspects of life. Our attitude right now is affecting the people around us. When we're in a great mood and we compliment someone, it makes them happy. The same goes for when we say something mean to someone and it causes them to have a bad day. But as we move through classes and breaks, it's easy to get caught up in our own worries and concerns. Then, it's hard to be positive. I try and fail constantly, accidentally sending out negative vibes instead of the good ones I want to share, because I'm absorbed by my own problems. That's because life throws us curveballs. Negative stuff is real, and phony positivity and unrealistic hopefulness doesn't help anyone. How do we find a genuine way to be positive, even when we are worried or disappointed? During the high school process, it was hard for me to be positive, especially during the period of waiting to find out about admissions decisions. Personally, I made the choice to apply for just a few highly competitive schools. My preference was to go to my local public school over some of the other, less competitive private high schools. With the rest of my class, I was nervous for the day we would get our high school letters, and of course, I hoped for the best. I didn't know what to expect, and I didn't want to consider the possibility of rejection. I had been through this process before when I applied to St. Matthew's as a fifth grader, and I knew the drill. Waitlist is a small envelope, big envelope is an acceptance. On the day the letters came, I took one look and I knew my fate. I had no big envelopes. I opened them and we waitlisted at all my schools. I was devastated. I'd heard stories about this, but I hadn't really considered that it might ever happen to me. I desperately wanted to talk to my friends and share my disappointment, but on the advice of our teachers, we had decided not to talk until the next day, so we all had time to let our news sink in. I later found out many of my class's friends had been accepted to their top choice schools, which only made me feel more negatively about myself. Of course, I was excited for my friends, but I felt very alone. I tried to stay hopeful because I heard of students getting off the wait lists, but then emails came saying classes were full. It finally sunk in that I wouldn't be going to those schools. First, I thought about everything I could have done wrong. I know I'm not a good at standardized tests, so maybe I should have studied harder. I also believe my good qualities would outweigh any of my limitations. St. Matt's is amazing for making us feel confident that we are talented, special students, but then made it hard to realize there were 500 other qualified kids gunning for the same spot I wanted, and I wish to embrace myself for this possibility. Even though Mr. Gemerson and Mr. Robinson told us the admissions were super competitive, I didn't prepare myself to get those no's, and they were hard to deal with. I got stuck in a very negative place for several days. Finally, when my dad and I was ready, he gave me a big hug and we talked about how going to Burlington High School could turn out to be a great opportunity. His grounded, realistic positivity helped me get out of my funk. I realized I could try out for the cheer team at BHS and take advanced classes. Later, I learned that I was not the only one going through the waitlist process. Other classmates were on the roller coaster with me, and others were planning to go to BHS because it's a great school. My classmates reminded me of all the things that made BHS such a great school, and all the opportunities I could take advantage of at such a big school. Hearing that I wasn't alone gave me hope that even though I didn't get where I wanted in the beginning, everything would be okay. Once again, I had a reason to stay positive and keep working hard. Now I'm excited about going to BHS, especially because I made the cheer team. Still, if I thought more about the possibility of rejection, I would have been more prepared for it and able to see the silver lining faster. In the scripture lesson Oliver read for us, it tells us to never stop being happy, to be thankful for all the good things in our lives, even when bad things happen, and to never silence the little voice inside, the angel on your shoulder who tells you to keep hoping. It tells us not to stop what life has to offer us and that God will always stick with us through hard times. In the end, I believe there is a reason I was waitlisted and I am now stronger for it. I know in the future when I do this whole process again to apply for colleges that I will never let them doubt me or why I'm a great fit for their school. So guys, try to spread positivity, but also be realistic about the possibility of disappointment. Help others the way my dad helped me to see the glass was half full. You never know if someone needs a little pick-me-up, but you always know it can help when you lift your head from your own worries to offer a smile compliment, or an encouraging word. We might just change someone's day or help bring them out of our funk. It's not always easy, but it always makes a difference. If we know someone is really down, we can be friendly, and when they are ready, we can remind them of all their many gifts and opportunities. If we strive to be authentically positive throughout our day, it will spread happiness all around. The world can be filled with so many positive people because you decided to do something. Don't you want to live in that kind of a world? Thank you.